somebody done been through the Walmart.
Man, this is the stuff I got for Christmas.
Well, you cleaned up. What'd you get?
Five little
shirts. Four Big Mud tires, three shotgun shells, two hunting dogs, and some parts to a Mustang GT.
You fool, you got gypped. There's 12 days to Christmas.
I know that. I got it covered. Look over in the corner.
That's yours, too?
Yeah. 12 pack of Bud, 11 wrestling tickets, 10 of Copenhagen, 9 years probation, 8 table dancers, 7 packs of Redman, 6 cans of Spam. Four Big Mud tires, 3 shotgun shells, 2 hunting dogs, and some parts to a Mustang GT.
Man, these ain't normal Christmas presents.
No, they're redneck gifts.
Redneck gifts?
Yeah, you know, like if you buy your wife earrings and double as fishing lures, or if you can burp the entire course of Jingle Bells. Perhaps if you think the Nutcracker is something you did off the high dive, or if you ever misspelled anything in Christmas lights, or if you leave cold beer and pickled eggs for Santa Claus.
What's wrong with that?
I didn't say anything wrong with it. It's hard to beat. 12 pack of Bud, 11 wrestling tickets, 10 of Copenhagen, 9 years probation, 8 table dancers, 7 packs of Redman, 6 cans of Spam. 4 Big Mud tires, 3 shotgun shells, 2 hunting dogs, and some parts to a Mustang GT.
Well, you know, you can't really consider it a Christmas unless you go down to the penitentiary and visit your mama.
You're not listening to me. Get the car key out of here. That's where the 9 years probation comes in. I'm going to do it for you again. Now listen. 12 pack of Bud, 11 wrestling tickets, 10 of Copenhagen, 9 years probation, 8 table dancers, 7 packs of Redman, 6 cans of Spam.
Yee-haw!
4 Big Mud tires, 3 shotgun shells, 2 hunting dogs, and some parts to a Mustang GT. Are you crying?
Nah, that's my allergy.
Happy holidays, everybody.
Grandma got run over by a reindeer. Walking home from our house Christmas Eve. You could say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and Grandpa, we believe. She'd been drinking too much eggnog, and we begged her not to go. But she forgot her medication, and she staggered out the door into the snow. When we found her Christmas morning at the scene of the attack, she had hoof prints on her forehead and incriminating claw marks on her back. Grandma got run over by a reindeer walking home from our house Christmas Eve. You can say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and Grandpa, we believe. Now we're all so proud of Grandpa. He's been taking this so well. See him in there watching football, drinking beer and playing cards with Cousin Ned. Well, it's not Christmas without Grandma. All the family's dressed in black, just can't help but wonder, should we open up her gifts or send them back?
Send them back!
Grandma got run over by a reindeer walking home from our house Christmas Eve. You can say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and Grandpa, we believe. Now the goose is on the table, and the pudding made of fish.
Ha!
And the blue and silver candle that would just match the hair in Grandma's wig. I've warned all my friends and neighbors, better watch out for yourself. They should never give a license to a man who drives a sleigh and plays with elves. Grandma got run over by a reindeer walking home from our house Christmas Eve. You can say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and Grandpa, we believe. Sing it, Grandpa. Grandma got run over by a reindeer walking home from our house Christmas Eve. You can say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and Grandpa, we believe. Merry Christmas.
Was the night before Christmas, and so far from home, a sad elf was using his cellular phone.
Santa, help me, Santa. Rudolph's sick in bed. That's where he stays for six more days, so the dear doctor says. With Christmas night upon us, I ask you what to do. Say, go recruit a substitute at the Eskimo County Zoo. Now he ain't much to look at, and his nose won't glow in the dark. I tied on a fluorescent light bulb and a battery pack to give it a spark. I hooked his head to the loaded sled, sprayed the magic dust on. Went to set it down before I could turn around. He was up and gone. And I've been chasing that neon reindeer back and forth across the sky. The worst mistake I could ever make was to teach that booger to fly. Wise men whooping their camels, trying to follow me from afar, all because that neon reindeer looked like a moving star. If he keeps on sniffing ozone, there's no telling what he'll do. I'd let him sail away, but folks are gonna blame all this on you. Why, he's placing bets and racing jets, I didn't see where all he went. But he made a run on Air Force One and mooned the president. And I've been chasing that neon reindeer back and forth across the sky. The worst mistake I could ever make was to teach that hat rack to fly. Flying circles over Nashville, playing some kid's guitar. And now that neon reindeer thinks he's a country star.
Chasing that neon reindeer.
I guess I'll just have to keep on following him until his batteries run down. Oh, we got company. A pink rabbit. Wants a new drum, no doubt. He's putting some up on his back. You little geezer. Oh, this ain't never gonna end.
Never had a haircut, never took a shave. Boogie Woogie Santa Claus, Boogie Woogie Santa Claus, the Boogie Woogie Santa will boogie all your blues away. Rock, 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 Mr. Santa. Jump, 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 Mr. Santa. Tree or candy for your socks. When he starts to boogie, the whole town rocks. Rock, Mr. Santa. your hat, put your best dress on. We're gonna really jump for joy on Christmas morn with the boogie woogie Santa Claus. Boogie woogie Santa Claus. The boogie woogie Santa will boogie all your blues away. Rock, 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 Mr. Santa. Jump, 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 Mr. Santa.
Well, you've all heard the story about Rudolph and his nose, but I'll tell you a Christmas tale that never has been told. Well, you may think you've heard it all, but you ain't heard nothing yet about that crazy Christmas that the North Pole can't forget. Rudolph was under the weather and had to call in sick. So he got on the horn to his cousin Leroy, who lived out in the sticks. He said, Santa's really counting on me, and I hate to pass the buck. Leroy said, hey, I'm on my way, and he jumped in his pickup truck. When Leroy got to the North Pole, all the reindeer snickered and laughed. They'd never seen a deer in overalls and a John Deere tractor hat. But Santa stepped in and said, just calm down, 'cause we all got a job to do. And like it or not, Leroy's in charge and he's gonna be leading you. And it was Leroy, the redneck reindeer, hooked to the front of the sleigh, delivering toys to all the good old boys and girls along the way. Just a down-home party animal, two-stepping across the sky. He mixed jingle bells with a rebel yell and made history that night. Before that night was over, Leroy had changed their tune. He had them scooting the hoof on every single roof by the light of a neon moon. Santa wrapped his bag with a Dixie flag. He was having the time of his life. And you could hear him call, Merry Christmas, y'all, and to all of y'all a good night. And it was Leroy, the redneck reindeer, up to the front of the sleigh, delivering toys to all the good old boys and girls along the way. Just a down-home party animal, two-stepping across the sky. He mixed jingle bells with a rebel yell and made history that night. He mixed jingle bells with a rebel yell and made history that night.
Thank you.
night on a Christmas Eve, when I saw a spooky sight, one you'd never believe. All tuckered out and bone-tied, weary Santa Claus came my way, dragging his reindeer across the prairie, hitched to a big red sleigh. Santa got lost in Texas and didn't know how to leave. Santa got lost in Texas on a Christmas Eve. Sit right down and rest, I said, here by the campfire's glow. Share my coffee, beans, and bread before you have to go. You're pretty dumb like me to sit and work in the winter frost. I'm pretty dumb like you, I said, but mister, I ain't lost. Santa got lost in Texas and didn't know how to leave. Santa got lost in Texas on a Christmas Eve. I've been riding along, says he, looking for just one guy. Texas is too big for me, too dang wide and high. I'm leaving you a big lone star on a pair of silver spurs. Here in the land of cattle farming, my last stop was yours. Santa got lost in Texas and didn't know how to leave. Santa got lost in Texas on a Christmas Eve. So he ate my beans and bread and drank till my pot was dry. Merry Christmas, son, he said, and now I've got to fly. You keep watching the herd, old partner, don't let the doggies roam. I'll just send for Texas Northern, it'll blow me home. Santa got lost in Texas, and when he said goodbye, he left the Star of Texas a-blazing in the sky. As long as there's a Christmas and cowboys on the plain, Santa will come to Texas and never get lost again. He'll never get lost again. Hey guys, what's the problem?
The weather.
What do you mean? It's warm and beautiful outside.
Exactly. No snow, no Santa, which means I've been good all year for nothing. This is going to be a miserable Christmas.
Well, maybe not, fellas. Well, I've been sort of worried about Santa Claus this year.
You're worried? My life's riding on this delivery.
'Cause we live way down south and it didn't snow down here. But I'm telling you not to worry, 'cause I just got the word. Everybody listen closely and I'll tell you what I heard.
What?
Santa's coming in a pickup instead of his trusty sleigh. He'll have a truck instead of a reindeer to carry him on his way. 'Cause the weatherman had some problems, he couldn't get snow, you see. Santa's gonna come in a pickup truck when he visits you and me.
This is great, 'cause this means we can get our presents. What are you asking for, Alan?
Well, you know, peace on earth and goodwill toward men.
Excellent. More room in the pickup for my stuff.
Alvin, don't you think you might be missing the point of Christmas?
Nope.
Santa can't bring his reindeer and leave them far away. But don't you worry about him, he's gonna be here Christmas Day. He's got a big red pickup with a four-wheel drive and all. And there's gonna be a Merry Christmas for all. Santa's coming in a pickup instead of his trusty sleigh. He'll have a truck instead of a reindeer to carry him on his way. 'Cause the weatherman had some problems, he couldn't get snow, you see. Santa's gonna come in a pickup truck when he visits you and me. Yeah, Santa's gonna come in a pickup truck when he visits you and me.
Well, Alan, about this pickup, we're talking really huge, right? And not one of those mini cabs.
Well, I'm not sure, Alvin. Why? What are you asking for?
A plane.
You mean one of those remote things?
No, a 747. I don't think a pickup's gonna cut it, Alan. As long as he's changing his means of transportation, why doesn't he drive a train?
A train?
A train wouldn't be practical, Alvin. It needs tracks, so it could only stop in certain areas.
Guys, I gotta tell you, man, you're really missing the point here.
Wait, I know. What about a blimp? Brilliant, Theodore. Alan, call Santa. He'll listen to you, especially since you don't want anything.
I'm not calling Santa, Alvin.
Tell him to dump the pickup. We need something much bigger.
No, you need to think much smaller.
Easy for you to say. You're not a kid anymore.
Even as a kid, I never asked for a 747.
Well, that's because they didn't have them when you were a kid.
Hey, I'm not that old.
Simon, get Santa on the phone. Tell him that Alan Jackson, the famous country singer, wants to talk to him.
Simon, put that phone down.
Hello, Santa?
Simon, I said put that phone down. Simon, put that phone down.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart an empty hole. Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole. You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch. You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile, Mr. Grinch. Given the choice between the two of you, I'd take the seasick crocodile. You're a foul one, Mr. Grinch. You're a nasty, nasty skunk. You're a heartless full of unwashed socks. Your soul is full of gunk, Mr. Grinch. The three words that best describe you are as follows, and I quote: stink, stink, stunk. You're a rotter, Mr. Grinch. You're the king of sinful sots. Your heart's a dead tomato splotch with moldy purple spots, Mr. Grinch. Your soul is an appalling dump heap, overflowing with the most disgraceful assortment of deplorable rubbish imaginable. Mangled in, tangled up, nah. You nauseate me, Mr. Grinch, with a nauseous super nuss. You're a crooked, jerky jockey, and you drive a crooked horse, Mr. Grinch. You're a three-decker sauerkraut and toadstool sandwich with arsenic sauce.